The first thing that always touches me or inspires me is the materials. There's something very primal, very basic, and very human about our need to gather onto us materials. And I'm sure if we check our memory, we all have a favorite stone, a favorite rock, a shell that we've gathered. And there's a reason that these materials call us. They speak to us. We know in our community, storytelling is a part of our lives. It's like the air we breathe. So my work is always based and underlaid with a narrative, a story that I want to tell. The narrative underlying the Scent of Magnolia, I'm sure we're all familiar with Billie Holiday's Strange Fruit. I wanted to encapsulate the kind of song and memory of that presence, and that these pod-like forms were ever changing and morphing. And at the same time, they feel like plants, they feel like animals. They move back and forth between the possibilities of what they can be. And I almost imagine the red kind of gashes or inner seeds become almost flesh-like. It was a huge garden. And there was a magnificent magnolia tree there. And I gathered up some of the pods and just took them to my studio. And of course, as the pods began to ripen and rot, they kind of spew forward this jewel-like red seeds. And I thought, oh, how magical, you know. I'm a sculptor, and you know you can't even get anywhere close to the magnificence of what nature will yield for you. So I often take notes from that, from the structure of how something is done.
I loved the artist explaining how she formed her creations. It was relatable for me. I have a magnolia tree in my front yard, and so the magnolia pods were quite intriguing, first of all, to see what they were. I'm a gardener, so watching those magnolia pods transform, like I said, they're in front of my business, my establishment, so when I go to work and I see the formations they take from day to day, is quite interesting.
This stone is really formulated in coal mines when there are fires underground, and if you look closely, the materials themselves, it looks like pieces of bark. So in actuality, it's petrified pine wood that gets fired in the coal mines. So it has still this memory of being wood, though it's stone. There's something wonderful, something inviting to me about the notion of building something that lasts. An important element for me is touch. And I know I'm in the museum looking at Andrea Julia cringe. But I'm always the person in the museum, they go, ma'am, don't touch the artwork. You're too close. But there's something about the tactile quality that invites you in. There's a narrative of motion, of the repeated effort. And maybe women, we do that best. You know, you can get onto something and, man, we don't let go of it until it is done.
I have to say, I'm just blown away by Martha Jarvis. This tiny, and she creates work that is so immense. I'm just blown away. I mean, everybody's work is so impactful. I'm just saying, wow. After finding petrified wood, I mean, I'm just blown away by that. And just the beauty of it. So, hands down, I'm a little biased. This is my favorite.
I really want the piece to draw you in, to not only touch it visually with your eyes, but to somehow have your spirit, to have touch it, to run your hands over, to feel the typography of the pieces themselves.